Hey, we've all thought about milking our pets before, but hopefully either morality or legality stopped us from tugging their tatas. The same can't be said for the farmer ant, since ants don't have morals and they've got too many arms to be handcuffed. These ants keep aphids as pets and tickle them with their antennae to milk them for honeydew. The only issue is aphids don't have udders, so this sweet nectar comes from their anus instead. In return for providing delicious feces, the ants take care of the aphids, feeding, housing, and protecting them, just like we do with our cattle. And just like how you close your door to force your cat to hang out with you, the ants sometimes bite off the wings of the aphids to stop them from leaving. If you think this doesn't seem like a fair trade-off, the next ant is much worse. Polyergus lucidus, or the kidnapper ant, must be a fan of Amazon because they evolved specifically for worker exploitation. These guys use the forbidden labor technique of stealing children and then brainwashing them into working for free. They start off by sending a scout to find other ant colonies to steal from, and once a target has been found, the scout comes back home to assemble a raid party. The gang then descend upon the enemy like a herd of millennial white women raiding a Stanley Cup display. And once they've breached the nest, the raiders make off, not out, with the captured young. They'll raise them from the pupa stage up to adulthood, at which point the kidnappees will have been imprinted on and brainwashed by their masters. Now, I know putting all your evolution points into slavery is a bit weird, but so is turning into a door. This technique is called phragmosis, and it's a defense mechanism where a creature anamorphs part of their body to block nest entrances. The trait can be seen in some frogs, spiders, aphids, and of course, the aptly named doorhead ant. I don't have too much to say about these dudes. They've just got a door for their head, and they use it to block stuff. It's pretty cool. The next critter I want to talk about is the driver ant. These guys are known for being the most aggressive ant species, but you probably know them from that one scene in Indiana Jones. And while it's not as dramatic as it was in the movies, these ants do swarm in the thousands. They're also huge, being up to 2.5 inches long, which most women would agree is way too big. They're so big and aggressive that they're able to take down lizards and small rodents, and there's even some sketchy stories about them eating human babies. And since their heads are so large and their mandibles are so strong, the Maasai people of Africa use them as stitches in an emergency. They make the ant bite down over an open wound, which seals it, and then they just rip off the body, which leaves the ant in place for at least a few days. The fourth ant on this list is called Formica archboldi, or the much cooler name, the headhunter ant. These psychos are known for decorating their homes with the decapitated heads of other ants. Scientists aren't sure why they do this, but it might be to disguise their nest from the kidnapper ants from earlier. This behavior is weird because the ants that they usually hunt, trap jaws, are much stronger than the headhunters, but it seems like they've specialized in taking them down for the sole purpose of scaring away their kidnappers. Moving on to the next ant, we have Colobopsis explodens. In the same way I greet the IRS agent at my door with 4 pounds of high explosives strapped to my chest, the unaliving ant greets its opponents with a lethal explosion of goo. But unlike myself, these guys don't just bust goo for fun. In fact, they prefer not to because the act of releasing the goo kills the ant. So they only do it if they're losing a fight and their colony is at risk. When they've decided it's time to blow up, they grab onto their opponent and flex so hard their abdomen bursts. This releases the goo that glues the ant to its opponent, which kills them both. This act of self-explosion is called autithesis, and it's seen in other types of ants, as well as some termites too. Anyways, enough about goo. The next ant is Myrmecocystis mexicanus, which is also known as the honeypot ant. I first heard about them from this comment on my animal abilities video. Now, when I saw this, I just thought this dude was some bug-eating freak. But it turns out, people really do eat these guys. At birth, they pick the biggest newborn to act as a living fridge, and then they regurgitate food into its mouth until the walls of its stomach expand to the size of a grape. These fridge ants are called repletes, and they get so big that they can't move anymore, so they'll spend the rest of their lives just dangling from the ceiling like a chandelier. In any given colony, about 1/5 of the population are repletes, and this allows for enough food storage to get the colony through hard times. So the last and most famous ant on this list is the bullet ant. It has a powerful neurotoxin that causes intense pain in humans, which is where they get their name from, because their sting feels like a gunshot. The Mawe tribe of the Amazon uses this pain as a rite of passage for young men. They stuff a bunch of bullet ants into a glove and force their boys to wear it for up to 11 hours, taking short breaks throughout. Now, even though the pain is incredible, there's little to no lasting side effects. I mean, if you really wanted to, you could die by one of these, but it would take at least 2,000 stings. Either way, the pain is so intense, it ranks at the top of the Schmidt Pain Index, but still pales in comparison to the pain I feel knowing that I might wake up tomorrow and have to live through another day. Anyways, that's all I got for you this time. Thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed. Let me know which ant you thought was coolest, and if you have any ideas for future videos. Also, thank you guys for 2,500. I love you. Mwah. Bye.